series against the Cavaliers last month in Ellensburg. Extended lead, runner goes, pitch high and outside. The throw tailing, but it tails into the tag. And Henderson able to get rid of it quickly to Chandler Williams to get the throw out. On a hop, nice glove by Williams. The throw to Herrera for one. The relay by Barrera. Between short and third, Crosby having a lot of success to the outfield today, and he leads off the ball game to sacrifice the runner over. We'll drive one to center field instead. Hampson racing back, still back, and it's over his head to the fence. Crosby will round third and score easily. Barrera losing balance, but he'll go in head first with a triple and an RBI, and after being shut out in game one, and has another runner, which is 90 feet from home. Breaking ball to the right side. Les Meister will make the play to first. The run will score. 0-2 pitch. That one's playable. Walsh steps on third, throws across. Good play by Penny at first. And the Cavaliers. Towards the gap in right center field, Hampson racing to his left, won't get to it. Runner going with the pitch, and Barrera in to score, making sure he's ahead of the possible play at second, which also does not happen. It's a double and an RBI. Back at Hilken Stadium as the Concordia Cavaliers earn a split of their doubleheader, a 3-2 victory over the Central Washington Wildcats in game two of the doubleheader, joined by Cavaliers shortstop Andrew Barrera. I'm sure the triple had to be a highlight of the day for you. You were pretty pumped when you got in there.
Oh, yeah. I mean, struggled in the first game, not as aggressive, but then turn on the switch, second game, everything started working.
What made the difference between the two? Obviously, you're facing a different pitcher. That's got to be part of it. You're seeing the ball different, a different delivery. What else made the difference for you in that second game?
Just loosening up, having the guys in the dugout, backing me up, backing the pitcher up. It just all helps you feed off everyone.
What's different about this team now in the second half of the season? I mean, you had a couple bounce backs against St. Martin's. You're starting to get the momentum. You come back from a shutout in game one of this one with a lot of energy as well. What's changed as this season has progressed?
Just believing. Just got to believe you can do everything, and then everyone will pick each other up.
And that belief building just as a matter of results in the second half? Or?
I mean, you just gain confidence as you go, and then you just feed off each other.
I'm sure it's got to be a little tough with this continuing weather. As a hitter, I'm sure you'd like to have a warm day just once before the year's
we'll
over.
We'll get one tomorrow, but yeah. It's tough. Just grind it out.
Got to be a good feeling, though. I mean, they tallied a lot of runs against you a month ago in Ellensburg, and to come back. And yes, they were pretty strong in game one, but much better overall day for you guys, I'm sure.
Yeah, it was good. Pitcher shoved, threw strikes. And then we just got our outs, didn't make any errors.
Well, speaking of throwing strikes, the guy who did that here in game two standing by will trade places here with our sophisticated equipment. We thank you for the time, and good luck again tomorrow. Andrew Barrera stepping off, and Caleb Jones will come in and join us here, getting a complete game, his second complete game of the season in picking up the win. And only 90 pitches, you were pretty efficient here in game two.
Yeah, the goal every time you go out is to pitch to contact. You don't want to say let him hit it, but, let your defense play. You got eight other guys out there with you. You might as well let them play with you a little bit.
And you really had a good philosophy with that. Yeah, you mixed up speeds and, really threw a lot of off speed that kept them off balance, I thought.
Exactly. They're a great hitting team, so that was our plan coming in. Mix and match a lot of different pitches in different spots, and I definitely think we executed that well. You saw a lot of contact they had, kind of lazy fly balls, ground balls, things like that. So that shows the game plan was working very well.
It's got to be kind of hard for a pitcher. I mean, when you grow up as a pitcher, you want to throw everything 95, strike everybody out, dominate. Uh-huh. But to have the maturity to let your defense do the work for you, that's a thing you have to adjust to and come to terms with a little
Absolutely,
bit.
Absolutely, yeah. That's something, growing up through high school, my junior college to here, it's something I've adapted to more and more. And it's honestly very helpful. helpful. It's something that's really worked for me and clicked for me, and I'm going to continue to do it.
I know you had a stretch here where it wasn't so much running out of gas. I think it was just location where you bounced a few, and it was a little bit fun to just watch you kind of hop up and down on the mound in frustration. Yeah. What was going through your mind in that stretch?
I think I was just they were all curveballs is the thing. It was all the same pitch, and I think I was just pulling off on them too hard, you know, trying to make them break too much instead of just naturally letting the throwing motion do the work. But, yeah, that was kind of one of those weird things. I kind of had to take a deep breath and regroup myself a little bit.
Well, but you did regroup. A team that banged out 13 hits in the opener, you scattered 7 hits and go the distance in this one.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, like I said, they're a great hitting team, and the goal is to just pitch to contact. You know, they're not going to strike out a lot, which, you know, we knew that coming in. So pitch to contact, use our big park as an advantage.
Well, and on top of it, anytime you can keep a bullpen staff rested so you have that many more arms available for 2 games tomorrow, that's another advantage for the team.
Absolutely. I think we're in a great position going forward tomorrow with arms. Ready to win 2 games tomorrow.
How has this season gone for you? We've talked about the hitters progressing as the year's gone along. What's it been like for you as you've continued through your starts?
Progression as well, definitely. I think we've finally kind of found a combo of starters that's going to work for us, the 4 we got now, you know, mixing and matching in different games. I think we finally got the right mix. And, you know, the results are showing, and we're starting as a team all together to gain more confidence. You know, we know we've put in the work, and it's starting to show, and we're starting to get real excited about it.
Also has to be a good feeling as a team, not only the sweep last weekend with St. Martin's, but knowing now for you guys that you're kind of in control of your own destiny mm-hmm. with regards to the conference tournament. You don't have to hope for everyone else. You can kind of take charge of it.
Absolutely. That's a great spot to be in, especially, you know, down the stretch of a season. You know, we want to go in and take it one game at a time, and we know that if we win, we're going to be in a good position, and that's our goal every time we go out.
Well, congratulations on this one, another complete game, and back to Western Oregon next week, and that'll
yes,
be
sir.
Your next start, right?
Yes, sir.
All right. Thank you very much for the time. Keep it up.
You bet. Thank you.
Thank you, Caleb. Caleb Jones joining us here as the Cavaliers earn a split over Central Washington. They lose the opener 7-0, but come back behind Caleb's 90 pitches in a complete game to take the nightcap by a 3-2 score. Same two teams scheduled for an 11 o'clock doubleheader tomorrow. The weather's supposed to be better. The play-by-play will be better, too, for you because there won't be any. Some of us have to do other things on a Monday morning, but we hope you'll join us for all the action, and Joe will keep you updated with all the stats as the Cavaliers and Wildcats will wind up this series tomorrow. Our thanks to Andrew Barrera for joining us, along with Caleb Jones, as the Cavaliers pick up their 10th win in conference play. Same two tomorrow at 11 a.m., and we hope you'll join us then. Then it'll be followed by softball a week from today, next Sunday, between the Cavaliers and Wildcats.